to click back over to the game now so that we can...
Games!
Yeah, we're playing The Deadly Tower of Monsters. The original movie poster.
Oh, boy, and there's DVD commentary the whole time. A Steam Group.
That's the developer. Oh. Just play the game.
What are the options?
No, just play the game. We're going to start the commentary
track now. File 3. File 3 is the best file. It's tech.
Load it. Oh, it was doing L-O-A-D-I instead of counting.
But it only went to I.
Yeah.
So it's just loading.
My computer's always fast.
Loady.
I directed this Dan film Smith. Back in, well, it feels like a century ago. The studio asked me to provide a commentary. You can see the strings. This is adorable.
But we'll never finish it because it's an Atlas game. No fluff or
anything. Is it an Atlas game?
It is an Atlas game. Crash landed ship. Out pops our hero. Fearless Dick Starspeed. Dick Starspeed.
Gravora. Gravoria?
Alright, so other controls. So A, jump. Slap.
Oh. The ship's velocity reactor is damaged. I believe that I am stranded.
Just gonna shatter thing going. Of course, by actor Jonathan. Why does nothing? Went on to some minor roles after this. Oh, okay. I can just like destroy everything or just these boxes.
What does this box look like? This guy's got leading man written all over his face. I need to know who's doing the narrator voice because.
It's probably Felicia Day.
It's clearly not Felicia Day.
Maybe she's just really well ranged.
That's cute. It's kind of like Bastion, but 50s sci-fi movie.
Greetings, citizens of Gravoria. I am Dick Starspeed.
And I come in peace. Probably shouldn't have had Dick draw his weapon when he was talking about these. Maybe one day we'll go back and see.
Just kidding. And this is what people pay to see. A no-name middle-aged B-list actor duking it out with stuntmen and costumes. Such stunning choreography. And the extras in those robot suits really knew how to take a punch. No, literally. I told Jonathan not to hold back. Give it all to him. Kick him in the nuts and bolts.
Oh, you just... Oh! I'm falling.
Oh no.
There's pterodactyls.
Oh. Oh god, don't get hit.
So I can go faster. If I land squarely on that grain silo, I should survive this fall. The strings.
Yeah, that's definitely how it works. Now, but you could actually see the strings if you squinted hard enough.
Trick from back in the old days. You put a grain silo or some haystacks down and it solves all your gravity related problems.
Assassin's Creed.
Exactly.
What is this? Silver cog.
Some of my equipment was lost when my ship was shot down. But what later reports that my ray gun is...
If you hit the button during a cutscene, it does like the fast forward noise and skips it. Oh, I died. Sea monster, always patrolling the shore, eagerly awaiting for his next meal. That's cool. So we died already.
Oh no.
I fell into the water and it's just like immediately like a... Dinosaurs. Jeez. Get on the floor. Everybody walk the dinosaur.
Yeah. It's so cool how it looks like stop motion.
Yeah.
It's really clever. I love it so much.
Like some Land of the Lost.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm really excited to see that gorilla.
And all the plants look plastic.
Yeah.
have simians. It's not an ammo base, it's just charge, which is nice. Some health.
We got our fair share of nasty letters from scientists complaining about the portrayal of the dinosaurs. Was news to me. Apparently these stegosauruses weren't needed.
It's also not a stegosaurus.
Wow. No, that's what I said.
Oh my god, it knocked over the plastic trees. Ah, sweet.
Take my that, Stegosaurus. It's still like, in the way, though.
Gotta go around, man.
I don't know anything about this game. There's secrets.
Oh, he sounds like the guy. The director sounds like the guy who played.
SmackDown.
No, the guy who played Barrack in Korra, the scientist dude.
Okay.
Yeah, that's who it sounds like. Now I need to do it.
The Emperor's evil white apes are attacking.
Oh, jeez.
This is like Congo.
It's cool, like a dude in a suit.
See, that's the hard thing about watching the movie Congo, is to figure out which ones are real monkeys and which ones are guys in the suits. Oh, man, so I saw the Killing Joke last night. And they had the trailers for other, like the Fathom events, so the ones who host stuff like that.
Yeah.
And they're gonna have, like, super HD, like, Planet of the Apes, like the first one.
Oh.
Have you ever seen that?
Yeah, I had it on, I think I had it on VHS back in the day.
So, the best part about watching it on, like, in HD is that, like, it's one of those that's like the graphics were just, or I mean, like the special effects were just like, oh, these work because it's not HD.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
So like
tell.
You're watching it and you can see like the actors' like mouths moving underneath the rubber masks.
Oh man. Okay, I don't think that's him, but what I didn't know was that the guy who plays Barrack in Legend of Korra is the obnoxious announcer dude from Pitch Perfect.
Which one?
The guy who's always with Elizabeth Banks.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
That guy. This is probably not him, but he's doing a good impression of him.
So we've learned that the stunt doubles did not hold back either. That's why they put them in a space suit to cover the bruises.
Oh, jeez.
Our first attempt was kind of a disaster. Tried using real legs, thought it cut down on the costume.
Okay. I like laser bow arrows.
Yeah.
Actors ever. They don't sit still for a moment. And the second you take your eyes off of them, they're flinging their feces all over the place. Jonathan refused to work with them after he got a... Well, it's...
Pew, pew. Just say
dinosaurs and monkeys.
Had to take more than a couple of showers. One day. You know, you never forget the smell of monkey poo.
Get out.
How are you finding the gameplay?
It's good. I mean, guys, you gotta... They just learn the... Like them, like Yetis?
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of like you gotta learn the enemy's attack patterns.
Oh, okay. Silver cop.
The game's pretty forgiving when it comes to health.
Yeah, I noticed that. It looked like you were getting beat up, but you still had, like,
full health.
More than 75% health. Hey, Darth. Welcome to the stream.
Hey.
Are you brave enough to climb up to the altar? Oh, the Mega Gorilla.
The Mega
Gorilla.
I saw this guy in the trailer, and I really wanted to see this scene, so.
Some really top-notch stop-motion effects.
Look at the hand, there's the sticks.
So good.
A lake?
A poking stick.
We're really ahead of our time with this scene, but again, I've always been really impressive. Zach didn't seem to get why it was such a big deal, though.
Sorry, we don't see this as anything unusual.
Of course, it's unusual.
Between the short stick that he had and that staff.
Ah. Oh, where's he going?
Dramatic rescues. All right.
We're supposed to be seeing Dick as Scarlet's first dialogue scene here.
So, like, if you hit A.
Fast forward. That's really cute.
Dun dun dun! We're in the Tower of Eternal Solitude for all eternity.
Oh man, that sucks.
Jetpack
usage. Jump. Wait. Wait. Use booster. Survive deadly fall.
All right. Ooh, a vertical ray gun.
Scarlet didn't quite realize she needed to shoot those energy orbs down below.
Ooh.
Keep in mind, Stacy was doing this on a sound stage, okay?
Cool, you can like aim down. Is it the red ones? Cool. Normally in games you're climbing up a tower, but this is kind of like both going up and down, which is pretty neat.
Space Invaders are there.
Cool. Watch those green things.
Anything up here we need?
I designed this creature to reflect the human condition. He's hungry, never satisfied. Bottomless pit of the beast's stomach.
Oh no!
Award.
energy amps.
Each movement frame by frame and superimpose it through live footage. We were pulling all-nighters for weeks. Well, when I said we, I meant the artist. I'm pretty much useless if I don't get a solid 10 hours a night. But they were at it forever. Yeah, they had to redo it all because
I... Can you jetpack over there? Yeah, use the jetpack to extend your jump.
It's gold.
Oh, it's money, okay.
They have not expressed what gold is for.
Longer than I remember.
Shut up. We're exploring.
I'm bad with Dick. What?
He's the worst. No, he's fine.
I knew you would return.
Puny Earthman?
Puny Earthman.
It's like a Fallout. Like fake movie, they would.
Yeah, they'd be watching in Fallout World.
This is practically Shakespeare in outer space. And huh? Patrick, what's wrong with the video?
Oh no.
Sorry, sir. Technical problems.
Darn it, we're missing some really good writing here.
There. Sorry about that.
Well, we just passed right by her big scene. Work together, but one must stay behind in the sleep chamber at all times.
Should I rewind?
Never mind. I'll continue from here.
I wonder if this game was meant to be co-op at one point. Because this doesn't seem like it is now. But if you have two protagonists, like... Usually.
So what I read was they kind of had different skill sets, and so you will like swap them as needed.
But it didn't end up that way.
I don't know.
Right from the start, our budget was a little tight, even by standards back then. To make do, Tony shot a couple of scenes in black and white. Originally, he intended to use them for flashbacks, but then I had to break it to him. Film doesn't have flashbacks. We almost made it a silent film just to cut costs.
Dinosaur nerdery in this game, and I appreciate that.
Oh no, giant crams.
Yes! Like, you can't have an old movie without giant crams. Pew pew. This is like a real thing.
Nothing like an adrenaline boost to get our hero to really start wailing on those monsters.
And it is like a...
represent a surge of adrenaline at first, but I think we nailed it.
It's kind of like a T-Rex, but it has like those horns on its head, like that one did. Cool.
So we need to keep ants off the roof.
Appear that now is the time for us to climb the deadly Tower of Monsters.
Ooh. Oh, spooky.
Good screenwriting,
We now have Sparky.
Ooh. Bats. Oh, I get to see the strings! That's so cute!
Unfortunately, those meetings ended in a much different way.
Is there like a menu you can go into where you like equip stuff or?
No.
I guess not. It's just all different buttons.
I guess. Does this all work?
What's that ability?
Is there a
shield?
Spark thing, yeah.
Oh, here we go. Absolute zero. Oh, I guess you buy upgrades. Astronaut. Oh, everything about this game is adorable.
Is it like a one time?
I assume so.
I guess so. Not there.
First headline is beloved cat grabbing his job at local public library. The second headline is, beloved cat will keep his job at the local library after international backlash. Oh my goodness.
Ah, the squids. Some board member had these nephews who really wanted to be in the films.
Josh says this game looks fun.
Them as squids.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Yeah.
It seems like a kind of basic hack and slash, but like there's so much charm.
It really, like, the like aesthetics of the game is what's keeping me with it. No.
Yeah. Blue cog. What those are for? Sweet. What's that thing down there? No. Ah. Oh, cool. You got a gold cog. Can you teleport? Oh, you can just go there. Hang on. Did you get that one already?
Oh, that is.
Blue cog, I thought.
Oh. I thought that might be a teleport square.
Elevator.
Try for that other cog?
Yes! You can do it. I believe in you. You did it! You just go straight across. No! There you go.
There we go. We have a lamp that we never use.
It doesn't have a lampshade on it.
That's one of the reasons.
It's a nice lamp.
Oh, you don't want to miss a single minute of this scene. The nuclear ends.
Oh god, they're climbing up the side.
Whoops-a-dad. Lodi.
Oopsie-daisy.
you a kid or are you a screw? Ooh.
Don't get attacked by the worms. For money, honey.
Cogs?
Yeah.
No idea.
I'm not taking it back.
We'll figure it out.
Can you teleport? Don't die. Pro tip.
Don't die. This is why you're in charge of the channel.
Backward didn't work. Can you just teleport back?
Oh.
Why don't you try it?
I think I went to the wrong point.
Oh, there's a cog machine over there. I mean, that does stuff.
You're crazy.
With the cogs. Oh, it's like upgrades for your weapons.
Ooh, a pointy end. More balls on a ton. Shit, if he stands on your enemy's life. I'm gonna go with.
Ooh, it's like a trident now?
So, no, now I have the tribal spear. I could, if I had two more gold cogs, make it the trident of the overlords.
Besides, everybody was doing the alien thing back then. You know me, I'd rather be a trailblazer.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God.
That's one of my goals in life. Up the tower.
And you're an acrophobic ape? Tesla gun. Space baton. Sparky. Oh, you choose your equipped weapon.
This tape on the outside of the level. Because the actors kept falling off.
Oh no.
So their insurance man made them do it. It didn't stop them from falling off. But it just made them less liable.
You can't click anything on them there?
I don't know.
Weird. Can you level up the other guy?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I guess it's time to talk about the elephant in the room. Why on earth does this crazy film have title cards on screen when people aren't talking?
Oh, I guess not. That's cool that the level up things with
your
vocal.
You're thinking that, aren't you? I know you are. I would be too. Well, So we shot a lot of scenes up close like this with the dialogue written out.
Oh, now you can shoot those.
Well, when we swapped over to making a talkie, well, we just decided to keep on going.
Yeah, cool.
Oh.
And a cog. Sweet. You're so good at this game.
So we're probably gonna go back to Alex playing
Quest for Glory 2.
Quest for Glory 2.
Next week.
Yeah, we didn't go retro games this week, but we went retro looking games.
It's true. Oh, Snake Man.
Beetlejuice.
Oh, an eyeball.
Beholder.
Oh no, he exploded. Oh. He barely did any damage.
Higher and higher we go into the Tower of Monsters. I cannot handle the dinosaur nerve in this game. It's amazing. The bones. Game got spooky. We now have a morning star.
Really oh, sweet. We're in a spooky castle.
It's super spooky.
Oh, no. That won't come by glitter. Oh no.
It's like Tingles Island.
Honey, I'm sorry to be the one to tell you this, but Asuka was tweeting about video games, and she tweeted that Tingle was the Trump of Zelda.
No, she's wrong. I'm gonna...
She's wrong.
I'm gonna make a sign for a takeover. Asuka is now the Empress of Lies.
Horror movie set in Pennsylvania. So we signed a soft contract with them to use their set after they wrap for the day. And by that, I mean we kind of snuck in and filmed it real quick when no one was looking. I had my assistant Phyllis keep a lookout for the security guard.
Man, how do you get rid of those? There's gotta be a way, right? Because there was one earlier. Whoa, what was that?
That's my force push ability, but... There's the, what's it called? The instrument. The theremin.
Yeah, it is! Oh my god.
Whoops.
No!
I don't know, like laser arrows, but they still bounce off you.
Yeah. Really just an effect.
Sorry, sir, but I don't think that would be appropriate.
Man, you're no fun.
They're coming from below.
Yeah.
Oh, here you go.
Scarlet using the landmines, but then I came to my senses and we reshot with him.
Rude.
I mean, a woman using high explosives?
The tone, that was great.
This may be a science fiction, but we have to keep things at least somewhat believable.
Rude. I guess you can use them on the... those big bowlers. Or maybe not.
Hey, most days,
oh, there you go. Oh my god, they deflate! That's amazing.
But these, deflating rock
Or you could backtrack to that other place and get the,
God.
That's pretty sweet music.
The music is really sad.
Deflate! No!
He played basketball in college or something, because he leaped right at the last second. Woo! Crisis averted. My props guy wanted to swap them with some spongy material for safety, but I had a better idea.
Oh,
let's
wow.
Set the logs on fire. Then the crew will be sure to be safe dealing with them.
Oh,
we created these conveyor belts for Stacy's character. Jonathan was always trying to run across them to no avail. I probably should have told him that we slowed the belt down whenever Scarlet runs across, but I got a real kick out of watching him try.
Maybe you can do it with her character. No, the camera does not move fast enough.
Yeah.
Can you aim it at all? Can you? I guess you can't jump like that.
Oh God.
Whoops. Bam. Just take the path.
But I'm a spaceman.
Okay. Go in there.
So the teleporter back is where I came in.
Oh, the spooky place.
We shot so much of this film outside. It was a nice change of pace doing interior scenes like this.
Did we post on Facebook that we're sharing?
I didn't.
Okay.
still can't run across them.
Oh, really? Oh, I guess it was just flavor text then.
What is that?
Just funny dialogue. Just teleporter. You can do it. Alright, continue!
You get like a power bonus the longer you go without being hit.
Ah, me.
Like the more hits you do without.
Right. Jumping and not reaching you, that's amazing. No, just stay there.
I know, you can see them.
Whee! Jumping to their deaths. Nice.
Here.
Kill all of them without actually doing anything. They had to work on your timing.
Yeah.
Just a little bit. Pew pew that guy.
Oh, so we're basically playing this because we don't have a good way to stream Pokemon Go.
we can figure out some way. No, we can't. No. We'd have to get like a camera.
We have to like
a Wi-Fi camera.
A Wi-Fi camera.
Well, a 3G camera.
You would have to like point your phone at my phone like the whole time.
Yeah, that's true. But we can talk about Pokemon Go.
We can talk about Pokemon Go. I got busted playing Pokemon Go at work.
You did, honey!
I'm gonna get in trouble. It's everybody playing Pokemon Go.
Uh-huh.
But I didn't know my sound was on, and so I turned it on, and then when you hit a Pokestop...
It makes that noise.
And my supervisor knew what it was. And he goes, "What's that noise?" And I said, "TurboTax."
What?
And he was like, "Oh, okay." So I was in the clear.
You got away with it?
I think he knew what it was.
Oh. That's funny. Yeah, I turned all the music and the sound effects off. And I only play when I'm out doing my walks, because I've been going on walks at work for months now, and that's great because now it's not suspicious when I go out for a walk and I've got my phone with me.
Work walks.
Yeah. Well, I like people take smoke breaks, so why can't I take a walk break?
I don't have a problem.
Funny story about the two kids. My work doesn't have a problem either.
I had completely forgotten about them when we wrapped up filming on this.
Oh no.
Then we spent the next day doing a location shoot. So suffice it to say, our return to the studio was met with a couple of grumbling dummies complaining about unsafe work conditions, human rights, yada yada yada.
This guy.
The sacrifice that they make for art is beautiful.
Uh-huh.
Yes. It's because I'm good at parrying. That's why they call me Melissa.
So they call you what?
Melissa.
Melissa? Oh, there's a cog up there.
There's a what?
A cog up there.
Yeah, it's in the cage though. I can't.
It's on top of the cage. Oh, you gotta drop down from above, I guess.
I think so.
Keep going up! Keep going up! I really love how you can just see everything. Like, you can see the whole game from where you are, pretty much. It's really neat.
The slim slides. Oh, it hurts them.
Sweet.
It hurts me.
Yeah. Not much, though.
No, you really didn't do damage.
Knock him over the edge.
Hey, Patrick, I was thinking we should take a little break and get a bite to eat. You like Chinese? I know a great takeout.
Well, we're not scheduled for a break for another few hours.
Nonsense. Hey, you have to try the shrimp. It's the absolute best, but, oh, hey, I feel like I should warn you. It gives me horrible gas. But that's okay, we're friends, right?
Really, sir. Studio time costs a fortune.
It's that money.
Good thinking. We could grab a real dinner together and go out for a night on the town. Yeah. Two young
bachelors up there
on the prowl. Say, where do you youngsters go these days?
Eyeballs. They're so creepy. Guess you gotta shoot them when they just explode. Never mind.
What?
Yeah.
I'm going this way.
Oh, you have the trash now.
Yes. His fingerprints.
Oh my god. That's fantastic. Yeah, good job.
Thank you.
good. We've got a new upgrade now.
Yes.
What's that one?
Melee, attack power up. Melee is really sweet.
Giant fan. Open max.
Story on Dick? Why'd he travel to Gravoria in the first place? Did he do any research before landing there? Did he have a specific mission in that region of space?
Patrick, if you keep getting bogged down by the details, how will you ever learn to just sit back and appreciate the work of art for what it is?
So I'm like out of mines, and I don't really know how to get more.
Oh, really? Do you remember the name of the place where the mines were?
I wonder if one of these.
Oh, I think only Dick can use the mines.
Oh, that's
yeah.
Right. Because women.
Yeah.
Dick
teleport. I just noticed the swirl transition. What's that arrow?
That's where to go.
Ah.
The yellow one?
Yeah. Sweet. That's so funny. Flamethrower! It's Murphy's Law.
What in the cosmos? It's my co-pilot's body.
Oh no.
I believe that I can repair it.
Yay.
Oh, that brain flying brain.
Oh, no. Oh god.
I am trapped.
Master Dick.
Alex is shaking her head pretty hard.
Options restored.
Yay! Oh, we can play as the robot now.
Must eliminate.
His voice sounds like one of those like chat programs from like.
Oh, it's like a text-to-speech.
Yeah, text-to-speech ones.
I bet you thought it was an actual robot, huh?
No.
He loved the robot actor, but because he technically wasn't on the payroll, he couldn't remember his name.
Oh no.
And so he couldn't put in the credits on the payroll, so no.
Oh my god. Shoot that sea monster.
Dick malfunction.
You love that joke. Yeah, that's so many ants. Gross.
That's what I was telling you about where you
Oh, the boost. Cool.
Yeah.
Oh gosh.
Dick.
I rescue Dick again.
Dick rescue.
Oh, they're coming from below.
Days are numbered. At long last, we have assembled our team.
Sweet.
A lot of reviewers and fans, too, always wonder why we shot so few scenes with all three heroes in it together. I mean, we did our best to explain it. Something about the sleep chambers or staying packed to protect the ape village. Really, it was just logistics. Jonathan had bowling league on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and Stacy had her karate Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Honestly, we almost never had all of them on the set at the same time.
Cute.
Our robot actor was in some religion that only allowed him to work on Sundays. I'm still a little skeptical about that.
I don't have to go.
Sir,
I don't know.
Guy in suit. Gotten just about anyone to stand in as the
robot. Go somewhere else.
See? That's why you'd make a horrible director, Patrick. His touches were subtle, to say the least.
Okay, I didn't know.
But he really brought a lot of character
he
to
has
the robot.
A power.
If he was so indispensable, how come you didn't list the actor in the
credits? Time?
Well,
yes.
Let's just say it was an oversight, but I've learned my lesson. I only made the mistake 6 more times throughout my career.
What are those?
What are those?
Get a sense of how high up our heroes have been climbing here. Reminds me of how the crew always used to comment on how high everyone was.
You got it!
Okay, there's stuff to get now. I don't want to wait.
I don't want to wait.
For our lives to be long. Did you just fall?
Yeah, I thought I was falling in my chair, but I wasn't.
You're the best.
Thank you. Top of the sneak tower. Oh, over there. Oh no.
No, no, Patrick. You got the wrong.
That's cute. I guess the red squares are his health?
Yeah.
Okay.
This scene reminds me of an RPG I want you to play.
What?
Not an RPG, not really an RPG. It's called Illusion of Gaia.
Oh yeah, you've been trying to get me to play it for years.
Yeah, it was really good.
Yeah.
It's like an old SNES.
Yeah, I forgetting whether I started that one or if I started Secret of Mana. Maybe I've started both of them. I don't remember.
Guest star is here.
It's Libby!
Never get enough of these free falling shots. There's something so invigorating and freeing about them. Like sticking her head out of the sunroof while driving on the
It's a pretty good place to stop.
Yeah, you gonna stop?
Yes.
Okay. Cool. Well, that was a good pick. That was, I really liked watching that.
It was fun.
Hope you guys enjoyed watching.
We'll go back to real old games next week.
Yep. Thanks for watching. Oh, I launched an Etsy store. If you want to check it out, it's Alex Lynn Crafts. Just Google that. The website will come up.
Versus keychains.
AlexandCrafts.com, and then there's a link to the shop there. Yeah, I got like cute stuff, so cute nerdy things. So if you like that kind of stuff, check it out. Or if you're looking for a gift for someone, check it out too.
People will love you if you buy these things.
They're really well made, if I say so myself. So anyway, thanks for watching. We'll be back next week, 9 o'clock Eastern, Tuesday. See ya.
Bye.